People say I'm crazy, dreaming my life away. They shake their heads and they look at me as if I've lost my mind. I tell them there's really no hurry, I'm just traveling around doing time. Mom and Dad probably instilled the idea I could do anything a little too much.
There's a gray stone chapel here at Folsom. A house of worship in this den of sin.
But what gets me out of this Folsom prison we call our world, back on these silly adventures, is that we have this moment now to change anything, to go anywhere. Everyone has choice when to and not to raise your voice. Jobs fill your pockets, but adventures fill your soul.
My body may be, but my Lord has set my soul free.
It's you that decides.
Solitude in the monastery gardens. But when traveling, it's so easy to become obsessed, and outside of travel too, of course, it's so easy to become obsessed with this mindset of what are we doing next? What are we doing after this? You know, we fetishize the things we're going to do, the people we're going to become, the titles we're going to attain, and we kind of forget to look at the ground that we're standing on. And we get to the end of the year and everything just seems to have been a blur, you know. We can't remember what we were doing last month or in July on the 23rd. And, you know, we kind of start to think, well, what's this the life that I've been waiting for? And the truth is that our past selves and our future selves, they hold no value to us right now. The only thing that matters is who you're surrounded by right now and what you're doing right now and who you are right now. And you should hold on to that with a silent comprehension and joy and enthusiasm. Be here now. But you don't need to be on an ancient Italian monastery to do that. Although I think it helps, right?
So this is where I'm living for a month on my travels, with many nuns and people like me on this monastery in Fabriano. No tourist hotspots, no giant malls. I barely speak the language, but it's more of an experience than any modern metropolis could ever offer. Because when you travel for people, not the places, live for something else, not yourselves, you'll awaken and see there's more. Seek for those places where you find yourself so content you wish it could last forever. Although if you're doing it right, it won't continue. You'll always be left wanting more, but this creates a legacy, an experience that changed you, and it hands you the responsibility to pass this on to your peers to inherit. You don't need no passport, you don't need a visa, just a sum of courage to leave your comfort zone to seek a more fruitful experience that will free you from anxiety and fill you with a greater sense of purpose.
you can keep chasing success forever, but a $30 watch and a $3,000 watch tell the same time. Alright. I think if you made it through that, you've earned a tour through the ancient Italian monastery. The first thing you need to know is that this place is an absolute maze. Even I don't really know where I am right now.
So this is my view, this is my floor, and my buddy Paolo's room who just left. This is the girls' floor with a much better view, but with humorously short doorways. This is our entrance lobby, the common area, the kitchen where I pig out, and the dining room where I pig out. The guest balcony, the guest garden, the nun's veggie garden, the nun's garden, where we broke world record for most weaning, by the way. The workshop where I break my fingers restoring furniture. A second common garden, my open window, which I should probably close for reference. And a grand maze of churches, chapels and gardens and the nun's courses, which I'm too scared to go through myself. I should probably just go close my window. Yes, the answer lies within, so why not take a look now? Pick up the devil's sin, pick up a good look now. This place really had become my own corner of Italy, my own city of Roma, and although I still had a week here, I already missed it. But like all the best things should, it left me grateful for what I had learned and hopeful that I could be the reason someone else could discover the San Luca Benedetto Monastery. Consider this your invitation.
Arrivederci, Roma.
Oh, post-credit scene. One cannot quantify how beautiful these empty Italian streets are and how peaceful the monastery is to stay at. And I'm genuinely serious when I say that this is an invitation, whether you're seeing it through my YouTube stuff or on their website or whatnot. I just figured out where to go. I like highly recommend staying at a place like this. It's amazing. Anyway, thanks for watching, dudes. I'll see you in one of my many other adventures.